Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Clicks with Q. Tonight's pinup is going to be the Silver Surfer. With the recent addition of the Fantastic Four Cosmic Clash starter set and the Fantastic Four set itself, we've gotten a few new Silver Surfers, so I'd like to go over those. But before we do that, I'd like to start with a little bit of an older piece from the Galactic Guardians set. So first we have Silver Surfer 036 from the Galactic Guardians set. You can see from his dial that his statistics don't really match up to what we would consider to be, you know, playable today, in today's standards. So what I've done here is I've incorporated a casual play point cost for him. So instead of starting him at 236, which would be, you know, a gigantic waste, as we're going to see in a second here, I suggest starting him at 125 if you're playing him with modern pieces. He has a trait called Defenders Ride With Me. Silver Surfer may carry up to two single-based characters, regardless of their combat values or possessing Battle Fury. When Silver Surfer carries only characters with the Defenders keyword or team ability, modify his speed value plus +2. So that's going to be pretty useful in if you're like a Defenders-themed team, moving people forward quickly. He also has a special movement power, a Distress Call half a galaxy away. Silver Surfer can use Running Shot, but doesn't have his speed value when using it. That's pretty nice. you can see that he's got hypersonic speed as well, so that's better than the Running Shot. But, hey, 12 spaces and then a shot after that of 8 range. Anybody within 20 squares is pretty much, you know, liable to get whacked pretty quickly. That's really all there is to say about this old Surfer. as you can see, his stats just kind of, they kind of flail about at the end there, so it's kind of a crapshoot if you want to run him. He's pretty useful on those first four or so clicks, but then after that, you'd want to keep him in the back and healing people. But that'd be an interesting way to run him as well, running him at 125 and then having him do a damage in the beginning and then healing people at the end. So yeah, there's that Surfer. Next up on the list, we have the Silver Surfer from Fantastic Four. This is 047A. There is an 047B Prime, which is the Skrull version of Silver Surfer. I don't actually own that one, so that's probably one of the reasons we're not going over it today. So this Surfer, same thing, real name Norrin Rad. He's got some keywords. First is Annihilators, Codex, Defenders, Fantastic Four, Cosmic, and Herald. So those are going to be pretty useful, especially that Fantastic Four one. Putting him on a team with Fantastic Four would be really great, and I've never done that before. He has a trait, Dawn Greenwood, Ordinary Girl from Earth. At the beginning of the game, generate a Dawn Greenwood bystander. So let's real quick go over to Dawn Greenwood, just so we have this in mind. Dawn Greenwood here, you can see she's got Sidestep with 6 spaces, No Indomitable, and some special powers and some traits. Let's look at those. I have to leave you now. When Dawn Greenwood is KO'd by an opponent's attack, modify Silver Surfer's combat values 1+ for the rest of the game. That is not to be understated how useful it is. But the real question is how you're going to force your opponent to knock her out, because if I was the opponent, I just wouldn't do it, which I have done multiple times. Special attack power. I might have gotten in over my head. Power. If Dawn Greenwood is within 4 squares of an opposing character, place Silver Surfer adjacent from elsewhere on the map. This is really useful because it's a power action for her, not for Surfer. So you can have him pop in and immediately do something and say, with his hypersonic speed, run right out. Happens all the time. Really annoying. But hey, really useful. Special damage power. I don't know how to feel about you, Norrin. Enhancement. Perplex, but only to target a character named Silver Surfer. So that's really what you want to do. Give her the power action to bring Surfer in from across the map, perplex him, and then use him to shoot somebody when he's standing next to her, and then run away. Very, very nice. Going back to Surfer's regular dial here, he's got a special movement power, anywhere and everywhere. Hypersonic speed. When Silver Surfer uses it, after resolutions, you may choose a hit character. You may choose a character he hit or moved through. The chosen character gains immobile until your next turn. Pretty useful, especially if you're going up against somebody who is all close range and no long range. Making them immobile essentially wastes their next turn. Special attack power. I only attack to defend. Free. Choose a standard attack power an opposing character within 8 squares can use. Silver Surfer can use that power until your next turn. Very nice. That also, of course, depends upon who is in your near vicinity. As we take a gander at his dial here, starting with probability control is going to keep him on that first, those first two clicks for as long as you can. Invincible's there. I'm always preferable to impervious, which he gets later, but hey, that's just me. Then he goes down to indomitable and eventually toughness and regeneration on his defense there. You can see that special power on his movement, ending it out with hypersonic speed. That special attack power, and then ends with nothing at the end there. And then, so after that prob, he's got outwit, shape change, and support. That support is going to be very useful if you can get him on that click without him getting knocked out after that. Because at that point, you're going to be further along in the game, and your people are going to be further along on their dials. So having Surfer be able to run up and heal them. Well, obviously, you can't hypersonic speed heal, but his speed and his ability to get to them quickly will be very useful. This Surfer can be run for 150 points or 75. He does not have the Defender's Team ability, although he does have the keyword, which is interesting. So he's primarily like a add him to a non-themed team character. So yeah, very, very nice. Last but certainly not least, we have the Silver Surfer from the Fantastic Four Cosmic Clash starter set. This is my favorite of the Surfers, simply because he's just so very to the point, I guess. Just looking at that dial, you can see this is just Silver Surfer at his strongest. So, he's got a trait, Behold the Power Cosmic. Free. Choose a standard attack power. Until your next turn, Silver Surfer can use the chosen power, and characters he hits can't use the chosen power. So just think about all those powers that could be. It could be Steel Energy, it could be Blaze Claw's Fangs, Energy Explosion, Penetrating Psychic Blast, you name it. Incapacitate? I mean, come on. That's incredibly useful. He has a special movement power, the Surfer Soars. Hypersonic Speed. When Silver Surfer uses it, he may be given a range action at no cost instead of making an attack. So this is where that Penetrating Blast comes in incredibly useful. On that first dial, on the first click of his dial, his 300-point dial, he can move 13 squares with his hypersonic speed, and then 8 squares away, penetrating blast somebody for 5 clicks of damage. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Even if you're starting him at 200, that's an 11 attack with 4 damage, penetrating damage. Next, he has a special damage power, tracking the subatomic across space. Free. Choose an improved targeting ability, except shooting through walls. Well, shooting through blocking terrain to use until your next turn. He may choose shooting through and destroying blocking terrain. That's interesting. Just kind of keeping it realistic, I guess, that he can't simply shoot through the walls. He shoots through them and breaks through them. Very nice indeed. So that'll be useful, especially if people have stealth. He'll just instantly see them. You can just say, well, I choose improved targeting hindering. And you can just, or improved targeting people. Hey, this is why this Surfer becomes incredibly useful, because he can kind of change his playstyle depending on what you're facing. And when he's not on those clicks where he changes his playstyle, look at that. Probability control the entire time. It's really, this Surfer is the primo Surfer. I'm really a big fan of pretty much everything that came from that starter set. And I'm actually really excited to see what the deep cuts of those figures are. I cannot wait to see the tiles for the deep cuts of Fantastic Four. I forgot to mention his keywords, Annihilators, Defenders, Cosmic Herald. So not as much as the other one, but still pretty useful. This one you can start at 300, 200, or 100 points. I would say his 200-point dial is the most efficient for the points. But it's always tempting to use that 3 and get that 19 defense with the 12 attack and 5 damage, 13 spaces. It's just mean, you know? All right, well, that'll be it for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed these figures of the Silver Surfer. We're going to see some more Silver Surfers in the upcoming Fantastic Four Future Foundation set. And actually, when that set is released, I'll be going over many of the figures from both the Fantastic Four set and the Future Foundation set. I'm actually waiting until Future Foundation comes out to do a full Fantastic Four team build video. So like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and stay tuned, there'll be more.